Beloved, we thank God for all he has taught us this week. We want to understand the nature of our warfare. We've learned that they are not carnal, they are not fleshly, that if we engage in spiritual warfare in the flesh, we are not even in the realm or theater of war. Not at all. Beloved, you ought to slap yourself for all the years you wasted doing the wrong thing, thinking you're doing the right thing. That's why I thank God every day for the revelation of the Word of God, because the Word of God is able to instruct me on a personal level. Most people pontificate, meaning they tell others, but they don't apply it to themselves. They read to teach, they read to preach, they read to counsel, but they don't use it for themselves. Beloved, a man of God said some years ago, if it doesn't work at home, don't export it. Meaning, if it hasn't worked for you, then don't run around talking about it. Apply it first. Learn yourself how to engage the weapons that will cause God to show up. Don't forget our text. I want to read one more time before we leave today. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, 4 through 6. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. In other words, you don't have to pray about it. You don't have to seek counsel on it. You don't have to even wonder whether it is legitimate or not. He said they're not carnal. So if it's carnal, it's not a weapon of warfare God will use. It's not. No matter how justifiable, no matter how many people agree with you, God will not show up. These weapons are not carnal. They are mighty through God. Mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Do you want strongholds to come down? Then learn what I'm saying. Learn what I'm sharing. That all these years you've wasted time arguing with people, striving with people, not forgiving people, judging people, talking about people, and the giant grows bigger. The mountains rise higher. The strongholds get stronger. It's time to whip the enemy with simple weapons that God gives. So these weapons are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ, and having inner readiness to avenge all disobedience when your own obedience is fulfilled. We will study this scripture next week in detail. I have some revelations from the Lord that will help you win in Jesus' name. I want to bring in another text before we leave. It's found in 2 Corinthians 9, 24 through 27. Paul writes, "Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize?" Only one. When you watch the Olympics, the time between the guy that wins the gold medal and the guy that is fourth or fifth, maybe less than 1 second. They're talking about 1/100th of a second, 2/100th of a second. How do you even calculate that? Did you get the clock to move that slow? Some of these races, they decide with a photo lens where they watch the pictures to see who barely made it past the other. That's how close it is. And you train and train and train every 4 years, for 4 years. And you go there and you lose by less than 1 second. It hurts, beloved. But can you imagine losing eternally? Wow. It was really hard. These guys get a chance every 4 years. This one is, that's it. So we cannot afford to keep warring in a fleshly manner. We must return to our senses and come back to God and learn how to fight so we can win. Listen to this. before my time runs out, he said, only one received the prize. But the great thing about spiritual warfare, that we can all win. But in the natural, only one gets the gold medal. He said, so run that you may obtain. And everyone that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. In other words, you have to learn to keep your cool so you can win. Because all those other things that come to move you out of the warfare is Satan trying to defeat you with the weapons he knows you've been using, which belongs to him. It's a mouthful, but I'm sure you get what I'm saying. Satan comes to give you what would defeat you, so you can use it and defeat yourself. Oh, beloved, I'm out of time, but it says, and every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. We an incorruptible. I therefore so run, not as uncertainly. Listen carefully. So fight I, not as one that beateth the air. Because if I'm using color weapons, I'm just shadow boxing. I'm beating the air. Ain't nobody there. The demons are not even in the scope of my punches. I'm wearing myself out and getting nowhere. Paul says, I don't fight as one that beateth the air, but I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, and lest by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway. Oh, beloved, study the scriptures. Know that God is speaking to you, and he's called you to win. And we shall continue our study next week. We love you. We pray in Jesus' name that revelation will come to you by this word, and the Holy Spirit will breathe upon you. Amen and amen. We'll see you next week. Pastor Chica, bye-bye.